G'day, I'm Clive and welcome. Just leaving the canning shelter on the Bibbulmun track, heading to the Monadnocks shelter, which is just over 16 kilometres away. Today's forecast is going to be sunny and 28 degrees centigrade. As you're coming out of the canning shelter, you follow the track right, and then there will be a warble pointing left, and not far after that there's another one pointing right, which leads you into the bush. So if you're not looking up after seeing the left one, you may walk straight past it, so keep your eyes open for that one. The track so far has been fairly level coming out. I know we've got one, maybe two hills to go up, but now this is just lovely. The noise of the Rookton Highway disappeared near the end of the Rookton to Canning. At this moment, walking from Canning out towards Monadnocks, there's no vehicle noise. It's just beautiful, it is. You can hear the birds chirping away. It's just great. Two kilometres in, and we've had a very gentle incline, which is still going up. Nothing serious, nice and easy, and the sun is coming out, so it's beginning to warm up now. Just listening to the nature, watching the kangaroos hop off. It's just beautiful out here. The further I get away from what they call civilization, which I don't see it as, the further away you get from the cities, the better I feel. It's just great out here. It's just beautiful. Thank you. That's over 12 kilometres to go. The walk so far, like I said, nothing serious, just gentle inclines and declines. And I've been on an incline now for about, I don't know, 1.5-2 kilometres, but it's every now and then you'll get a level bit and then it'll start going up again. Nothing serious, just nice gentle incline heading up. I met one chap back at the shelter at Canning called Ian. G'day Ian, nice to meet you mate. He's doing a sectional end to end. He's heading down to Dwellingham on this section now. And then the young couple just came by with day packs on. Maybe they've parked the car at one end and another car at the other end, and then they'll go down and pick the other car up. I met a couple when I was further down the track who was doing that. Two women, they'd parked the car at the beginning and one would park the car at the other end, and then they'd walk to the first car, vice versa. They'd park the second car where they're going, then the first car they'll take up to where they're starting from, walk down to the second car again, then drive to the first car. And they've been doing that all the way down, and that was just out of Donnelly River they were doing that. They've made it down so far, so that's good. That's one way to do it. Or the other way, public transport, bring it on, friends and family, or one of the shuttles in the towns. Right, let's carry on. Inclines have got a bit steeper. It's got the shade of the trees. Oh, that breeze is lovely. Still got the wildflowers out. I'll show you. Isn't that just beautiful? Another one here. Another one here. These, they just some yellow over there, more yellow, some more purple, some more blue. Worth it just to see the flowers. One thing I have noticed since I've been gradually losing weight, climbing these inclines, the hills, I feel my legs aching. But I don't seem to get out of breath, so that's helped big time. Met another hiker. She was heading south to north. Sorry if you're watching this, I didn't get your name. And I hope you enjoyed your brother's birthday party in Fremantle. And it's amazing how many people you meet on the Bibbulmun track and where they're from. Last year when I was out on a section of the Bibbulmun track, I met a young lady from Germany. She'd come over to do the end to end, and that was a good one because she bumped into me and she knew me as a YouTuber. So if you're watching this still, how you going? walking up from the Canning River. It's a steep one and it keeps going. Oh, mind you, stood under the tree here in the shade, just looking at that. It's beautiful. That was a bit of a struggle for me. I actually started from a Brockton campsite this morning. So I double footed. So what's that? That's about 12. This so far, so I've done about 24, 25 kilometres up to now. So I don't think my legs are up to that climb up that hill then. I stopped a few times to rest. Every time I saw a log which was at the right height to sit down on, I took the opportunity and had a drink. Now I'm going to push on now, so I'll show you a few more clips of the bush and then see you again when we get to the spur trail into the shelter. To the Monadnocks shelter spur trail. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to go and set up and I'll catch you another time. So I hope you've enjoyed the video, and if you have and you're not already a subscriber, please go down below and click on the subscribe button, click on the notification bell next to it and select all, hit the thumbs up button, the like button. And if you are already a subscriber, again, I thank you very much.